What are my options to treat my high, broad forehead and receding hairline? I am a male in my mid-20s. I've always had a high, broad forehead, but as I've gotten older and began receding, it has increased and I feel like it makes my face out of proportion. I take Propecia and Rogaine, but I feel Rogaine will not fix things. There's a 9 cm space from the lowest hair peak from my eyebrows. My hair is light brown and fine, but quite thick at the crown and back. Would I be a good candidate for a hair transplant as it makes me unhappy?
Thank you for your question. You're in your mid-20s. You submitted a photo and you're concerned about a receding hairline and you want to know what to do. So certainly this can be very distressing. Hair loss in your 20s puts you in the minority relative to your contemporaries. In hair restoration, we have a rule of decades that in your 20s, only 20% of contemporaries will have hair loss, while 80% will have a lot of hair. So it's very natural for you to be concerned about the receding hairline. It may be fair to assume that this is hair loss, that in fact there's a family history and this is your family's male pattern hair loss where you tend to recede from the front and you may have some thinning in the crown, but a lot of times when people have this aggressive loss from the front, that's a particular pattern. So that being said, your first options are still potentially medical options, and so you should be educated about what your medical options are. In the United States, the two drugs that are used for male pattern hair loss are finasteride, which is a 1 milligram tablet that you take daily by prescription, and the other is minoxidil. Minoxidil is a topical solution or foam that is applied nightly. Finasteride is used based on a concept and understanding that a substance in your blood called dihydrotestosterone, or DHT, can cause hair follicles that have a particular susceptibility to the DHT to thin and disappear. So the drug blocks an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase, which converts testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. Now, it has been in my clinical experience that a lot of younger males who have the frontal receding type of hair loss tend not to respond very well to finasteride. It may slow down to a small degree the hair loss, but a lot of times we have seen patients who were taking finasteride religiously and they still lost hair. Minoxidil is not likely to make a significant difference for you. It's a topical treatment that tends to make thinning hair look a little bit thicker or keep it on the scalp a little bit longer. So it leaves you then with the potential considerations of hair transplantation. And then I'll inform you about something that you probably have not heard of, and we call it hair regeneration. The past several years, we have been in a position where we have committed to helping our patients with a material derived from pig bladder called extracellular matrix. And this extracellular matrix was discovered serendipitously to help thinning hair when it was applied for a wound healing process for a hair transplant. As you may or may not know, hair transplantation is the movement of hair follicles from the back of the scalp in an area called the permanent zone or the donor area. Now, this area is limited, but when you do a hair transplant, you take out hair follicles, whether it's by a strip method or whether it's by follicular unit extraction, but nonetheless, you're getting whole follicles and you are planting them or placing them in areas where there's lacking hair. Well, when acellular matrix was used, it actually resulted in not only improved wound healing in that area, but also thinning hair became thicker. In our practice, we have developed a formulation, a method, a delivery technique that has helped people who have come to us from all over the world. And what we do is we combine extracellular matrix with platelet-rich plasma. Platelet-rich plasma is derived from your own blood. It is a concentration of your own serum and platelets, which have growth factors that seem to help the wound healing process. And although we don't know exactly why it works, the clinical data supports its tremendous success. Thinning hair becomes thicker, the progression of hair loss appears to be stopped, and it actually has helped a lot of our patients who are especially younger people, 20s and 30s, who have come to us distressed about their hair loss. In fact, it's actually changed how we practice in our office. We traditionally have done a lot of hair transplantation, and what we've done is we've kind of just flipped the approach. We actually will first, the majority of people who don't have a deadline, treat with hair regeneration and restore the hair that was thinning. We can't bring back hair that's completely gone, but if it's thinning, we can reverse that thinning and get the hair to be thicker. And so you may want to learn more about this, because if you have this progression of the receding hairline, it is possible, particularly if we look at you with a microscope or if you undergo microscopic examination of the scalp, that you'll find that there is a lot of hair that is thinning. Hair doesn't just fall. It just actually goes through a process where growth cycles occur, and when the hair is shed, and there's a normal amount of 50 to 100 hairs that's shed per day, when those hairs grow back after the catagen and telogen phases of hair growth, which is about 3 to 5 months, those hairs come back thinner. With our treatment, we have observed that the hair that is shed comes back thicker. The sustainability of this treatment has been documented for over 5 years. So with minimal or a handful of patients who we've considered reinjection. So it seems to be a tremendous benefit for people, both men and women, with thinning hair. So I think that my suggestion to you at this point is you need to at least have proper diagnosis. This may mean visiting a dermatologist, getting some microscopy done on the top of the scalp to learn if you are having significant miniaturization of the hairs, and then learn about the options. You may want to try taking finasteride first, using minoxidil, and then I would discourage you from transplantation, because the one thing that I did not mention in this question is that you still can lose hair, and that's why people need more transplants, is that not only do they want more density, but because their hair loss continues. So when you look at someone who has, quote, bad transplants, very often it's because their hair was fine when they had existing hair with the transplants. But once the hair thinned and disappeared, all that was left was the transplants, and that creates the pluggy look that everyone recognizes. So understanding that, investigate your options, medical and hair regeneration, and then pursue any whatever you think is right for you after consultation with qualified physicians. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.